do you surrender? Do you submit to Jesus? Satan has no way to live. He'll hang around, he'll stay, he'll buy. When you surrender to Christ, Satan has to live. When he leaves, he'll be fleeing. Come on, somebody. Had a lady one time tell me during an altar service as she was leaving, she said, "Brother Marvin, I gotta go." She said, "I enjoyed it." She said, "Well, I'm gonna do something the devil will never do." I said, "What's that?" She said, "I'm gonna leave you." I said, "You don't need to leave yet, you need to sit down."
Oh, amen.
I said, "Honey, the priest for you."
Hallelujah.
Because she thought she was gonna do something the devil would never do, because she thought the devil would never leave. I said, "Sister, what are we gonna do with Matthew 4, verse 11? Well, the Bible said in the word of the Lord, amen, that the devil left Jesus for a season."
Come on,
yeah. He left Jesus for a season.
Yeah.
Jesus quoted in his written, surrendered, submitted to his Father's will while he was in the wilderness. And eventually the devil, amen, glory to God, got worn out.
Yeah.
Somebody shout, "You can work the devil out."
Yeah.
Sometimes that's how you get him out, you worry about it. Somebody shout, "You hold on to God." How do you surrender to God? You submit to God. You come up under God's authority. Amen. You say, "God, not my will, but your will be done. I'm yours." Come on, somebody. I belong to God. I belong to you. Matthew chapter 11 verse 28 says, "Come unto me, all." Ain't you glad Jesus is that way?
Yeah.
He don't care what color your skin is, wherever you've been, or whatever you did when you were there, or who it was you did it with. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
He says, "Come."
Right.
John 6:37 said, "I'll in no wise cast out anyone that'll come to me."
Yeah.
That's the Jesus I'm talking about. The one who took his left hand and his right hand, amen, and opened them wide and allowed them, permitted them to drop spikes through his wrist, says to whosoever will, let them come.
Amen.
Come on, Revelation 22, verse 17. That's what the spirit of the bride said, come. Amen. Come. Everyone that's athirst, let them come. Somebody shout, "The invitation is intimate and it's to anyone."
Yes.
It's to all. Come on, so there's no select few. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. There's no elect few. Come on, somebody. Whosoever will, let them come. And in Matthew 11, 28, he said, come. Luke's neighbor said, "That's all you're responsible for." That's all Jesus thinks from you is to come. If he can just get you to come to him, he'll do the rest. But that's where we wrestle at, is actually coming. That word "come" simply means come unto me. Unto, amen, don't just mean to me. Don't just come to me, but come unto me. Somebody say, "Undone."
Undone.
Somebody shout, "Open up."
Undone.
Lord, I come surrendering.
Yeah.
I come giving up. That he's calling to come unto him in this manner. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. And I will. Somebody shout, "It's still his will." I will give you rest.
Yes.
Exodus 33 and 14, God told Moses, "My presence shall go with you and you shall have rest." Psalm of Solomon 5 and 2, Solomon said, the most wisest man that ever lived apart from Jesus, who is Christ. Hallelujah. Solomon said these words. He said, "I sleep, but my heart waketh."
Amen.
Somebody shout, "He slept."
He slept.
That meant his physical body had to sleep, but he said, "My heart waketh." In other words, he said, "My heart, my spirit never goes to sleep."
Amen.
Amen. Doctors say you need at least 8 hours sufficiently, amen, to have rest for your body. So it can recuperate. Come on, somebody. And gain back its strength. Amen. Amen. And Solomon said, "I sleep." He was talking about my body. He said, "But my spirit's still awake."
Amen.
Come on, anybody hear the Holy Ghost?
Yeah.
That's why Exodus 33 and 14, God told Moses, "My presence will go with you and you'll have rest." For your body to get rest, it needs to go to sleep. You may think you're Superman and Wonder Woman, but after a while, if you don't come apart, you're going to fall apart.
Yeah.
Come, your body was designed to lay down. Even the Lord the seventh day, come on somebody, to the rest.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. But for your spirit man to get a rest, it can't lay down on a mattress. It has to lay down in the presence of God.
That's it.
Come on now.
Amen.
The only rest your inward man can receive is from the presence of God.
Come on.
And Jesus was trying to let the people that were so heavy laden, who were laboring and heavy laden. Heavy laden would simply mean just bound down. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Undergoing. Just always uptight. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost?
Yeah.
Amen. Stress and filled with anxiety. Amen. Glory to God. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
And Jesus is saying, you got to understand, the only place there's relief from this is in my presence.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Some people think, well, there's relief from it if I can just sleep. Man, people that's depressed will sleep their whole life away and get up only to feel tired. What happens, you gave your body sleep, but your spirit ain't got no rest. People's trying to get their spirit rest with a pill. With an antidepressant, look at your neighbor and say, you ought to try a praise pill.
Yes, hallelujah.
You ought to try a gospel. Come on, somebody. Amen. His presence is where there's perfect rest at. Isaiah 26:3 said, thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon thee because he trusteth in thee. Those that trust in him will put their mind on him. Amen. And it produces a perfect peace. Somebody say a perfect peace. Psalm 16:11 said, thou wilt show them the paths of life. And in your presence is fullness of joy. And at your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Somebody say, in his presence, there's fullness of joy. Psalms 21:6 said, with your countenance, your presence, you've made me exceedingly glad.
Yes,
somebody shout, a joy.
Above joy.
My God, running over joy. It got said in his word in Acts 13 and verse 52, and the disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Somebody shout, the early church was filled with the Holy Ghost. In Acts 2:4, the Bible said they spake with other tongues. From the sanctuary. Come on, somebody. Amen. But you will speak with other tongues. Somebody shout if you get filled with the Holy Ghost. But they not only spake with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance, the Bible says clearly they were filled with joy and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Bible said in Romans 14:17, for the kingdom of God is not in meat and in drink. I know some people think it is. Welcome to church is chicken. They don't come unless there's a chicken being resurrected. Save the fried chicken. Amen. Come on, somebody. They've been to business. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Church folks are the worst about it. They can't get together without it. Anybody breathe? Call for a corporate fast. Anybody hear Holy Ghost? Hallelujah. Listen, he said, the kingdom of God's not in meat and drink, but in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Romans 14:7. Somebody say righteousness.
Peace, joy
in the Holy Ghost. Without righteousness, there is no peace. Without peace, there is no joy. But Ephesians 2:14 says, he is our peace. So I said, Jesus is our peace. Romans 5:1 said, we've been justified through.